Hey learners, welcome back to e-learning platform of TS College of Commerce, Vardha. This lecture is for the BCom Semester 6 English Medium for the subject Advanced Statistics. In the previous lecture of this subject, we had discussed the syllabus of this subject along with the paper pattern. We have seen how the traditional paper pattern is going to be for this subject. And we had also discussed about the another exam pattern which might be conducted if the situation of this COVID-19 would not normalize, that is MCQ pattern. So we will study the subject in a way that you would be able to solve the paper of 80 marks, and in case if there is going to be the MCQs, so you would be able to solve the MCQ as well. We are going to deal with the subject in that manner. I will try my level best to give you knowledge in that way only. So in today's lecture, we are just going to see the fundamentals of this subject, that is Advanced Statistics. So when I talk about the term statistics, so I'm sure it's not new for you, because when we talk about the statistics, so we have seen it in the school days. In mathematics, we used to have a chapter named statistics, so thereby we have seen it. Okay, we have seen the measures of central tendency over there, and we have seen the different things over there in this chapter statistics. Then when I talk about the college level, so when you were in, I think, 11th or 12th standard, so you have seen this chapter again, core level or the very basic level of this chapter in the economics as well. Okay, and in your first year again you have seen this subject. So when we talk about the subject statistics, so it's not new for you. Okay, you are already having little bit knowledge of this. So today we are just going to revise the introduction of that of this subject, and what we are going to see in this subject, and then we will start with the main content for next lecture. So let's begin with the meaning of statistics. When I ask you, what is the meaning of statistics? So what comes in your mind? Whenever we talk about the statistics, so the very basic thing that comes into our mind is data. Okay? So when we talk about the statistics or statistical technique, so it is a process of analyzing, categorizing, interpreting and compiling data. See, if you need to make any decision, so you need data, okay? And for collecting data, again you have two methods, primary method or the secondary method. But by any method, after the collection of data, what you need to do for making decisions? You need to analyze that data. You need to categorize that data. After analyzing and categorizing the data, you need to interpret it. You need to compile it, okay? And only after going through this procedures of analyzing, categorizing, interpretation and compilation of data, you can derive some conclusion. You can get certain results, okay? So this way, statistical technique is a technique which helps us in analyzing, categorizing, interpreting and compiling data. In business, this data sets are used to derive inferences regarding products, markets and consumer to make informed decision. See, when we talk about the business, okay, so business has to make n number of decisions every day. It has to make many decisions every day, and for making these decisions it requires data. But after collection of data, after going through all these procedures, business derived some inferences, and it uses those inferences for the purpose of decision making. So now, what kind of decisions are being taken in business? So there may be various kinds of decisions that can be taken in business. In business, there may be decisions regarding products which needs to be launched in the market or which are already being launched in the market. So there may be decision regarding the performance analysis of that product which is already being launched in the market, or there may be decision regarding the demand forecasting of a particular product which a firm wants to launch in a particular market. So this kind of decisions can be there regarding the product. Then It also helps to derive inferences regarding markets and consumer to make informed decision. So it also helps us to derive inferences regarding the markets and the consumers to make informed decision. So it also provides us insight for making the important decision regarding the business. Okay. When we interpret the statistical data, when we interpret the results of statistical modeling, so business administrative professional provide their organization with critical insights into current health of company. Okay, so after interpreting the results or the inferences that has been derived by using this data, the administrative personnel of the organization or a company provides insights to the organization regarding the present position of the company or the current health of the company, and this inferences also provides insight for analyzing the future prospects of the business. So this way, this statistical techniques help us in business. Okay, now when we talk about the statistics, so statistics has been categorized into two major disciplines, that is descriptive statistics and inferential statistics. Under descriptive and statistics, certain tools and the techniques are being used, and under inferential statistics as well, certain tools and techniques are being used. And these tools and techniques which are being used under the descriptive statistics as well as inferential statistics is used for the decision making in the business or for the purpose of research as well. So now let's see the meaning of descriptive statistics. What is basically the descriptive statistics? See, when we talk about the descriptive statistics, so in this type of statistics, the data is summarized through the given observation. Okay, the summarization is one from a sample of population using parameters such as mean or standard deviation. When we talk about the descriptive analyses or the descriptive statistics, so it is a way to organize, represent and describe a collection of data using different charts, pie diagrams, graphs, etc. For example, the collection of people in a city using the internet or using television is represented in the form of graph, in the form of table or in the form of pie chart. So it's going to be the example of descriptive statistics. Now when we talk about the tools which are being used under the descriptive statistics, so it is measure of central tendency. Basically, you know what is measure of central tendency. It's mean, mode, median. So when we talk about this measure of central tendency, so it is one of the tool under the descriptive statistics which is used for processing the data. Okay, the second one is measures of dispersion. So when we talk about the measures of dispersion, so it contains many tools like range, standard deviation, variances, etc. And this measure of dispersion basically helps to determine the spread of data. The another one is frequency. So when we talk about the frequency, so this is a tool which helps us to measure how much time a particular variable occurs or how much time the frequency measurement displays the occurrence of a particular number. So this way, these are the different tools which are used under the descriptive analysis for processing the data. The next type over here is inferential statistics. Now what is basically the inferential statistics and for what purpose this inferential statistics is used? So as the name indicates, inferential means to derive inferences. So when we talk about the inferential statistics, so basically it's a type of statistics which is used to interpret the meaning of descriptive statistics. Here we have collected the data, we have presented it in the form of chart, we have presented in the form of graph, pie chart, tabular form, etc. But here in inferential statistics, we try to interpret the meaning of that particular data. Okay, that means once the data has been collected, analyzed and summarized, then we use this data or the stats to describe the meaning of the collected data. Or basically we can say that this inferential statistics is used to derive the conclusion, is used to derive the inferences. Okay, so when we talk about the various techniques under the inferential statistics, so here we have hypothesis testing and regression analysis. When we talk about the hypothesis testing, so here the here some hypothesis is assumed, means some assumptions being taken, then the data is being collected, and after collecting the data, after performing the different tests on the data, it is checked whether the assumption that we have made is right or wrong. Like for example, we have taken the assumption that the COVID-19 vaccine which has been introduced in year 2020 is effective one. Okay, so to prove this hypothesis correct, now the data would be collected, and after the collection of data, some test would be performed on it, and on the basis of the test, it would be proven that whether the assumption that we have made regarding the COVID-19 vaccine is correct or not. So this way hypothesis testing works, which is one of the technique under the inferential statistics. The another one is regression analysis. Here again we study the relationship between the two variables, whereby one is independent variable and another is dependent variable. So we study the behavior of these two variables and make the equation of it. So this way regression analysis helps us, which is again one of the inferential statistical technique. So this way, if we talk about the essence of inferential statistics, so inferential statistics is a method that allows us to use information collected from a sample to make decisions, prediction or inferences from a population. So when we talk about the difference between the descriptive statistics and the inferential statistics, so basic difference between the descriptive statistics and inferential statistics is that descriptive statistics is a technique which is used to represent the data in different form. Okay, like it may be tabular form, it may be chart form, it may be pie diagram form. So it helps us to represent data in different forms. Okay, but when we talk about the techniques like inferential statistics, so here what we do, we use this descriptive statistical data for making the inferences. We apply the techniques and derive the inferences from the data so that the decision can be taken in course of business. So this way inferential statistics helps us. So these are the two major branches of descriptive statistics, that is descriptive statistics and the inferential statistics. Now why this statistics is important? What's the need of having this statistics? What's the need? Okay, so first here is helps us to examine different areas. So when we talk about the statistics, so I've already told you that the scope of this statistics is very wide. It helps us to examine various areas, different areas. Now what are those different areas? Those are business, so it helps us in decision making purpose in the business. It is economics, so in economics it helps us to make the various business model, or helps us to processing data for various techniques like demand forecasting. So this way when we talk about the statistics, so it helps us to examine different areas. The next one here is equips us with different kinds of organized data. So as in descriptive statistics we have seen that basically this descriptive statistics helps us to represent or it is a way to organize, represent or describe a collection of data using tables, graphs and summaries, summary measurement, etc. So this way it helps us to equip with the different kinds of organized data. Okay, the next one is provide understanding of variability of patterns in quantitative way. So for example, you have the data of sale of smartphones for 3 years, smartphones for 3 years, okay, 2018 2019 2020. Here your sales was 600 units, here 800 units, here 1000 units. So this data will provide you the understanding of variability of data pattern in quantitative way. Like here you can see the sales of the smartphones are increasing year by year. So you can predict the sales of smartphone in the future years to come. So this way the statistics helps us to provide understanding of variability of data pattern in quantitative way. Like here you can calculate the percentage, okay, or here you can see the numbers. So here we can see the variability of data pattern in quantitative way. So we can say that statistics helps us in understanding the variability of data pattern in quantitative way. The next one is way to collect accurate quantitative data. So again, as descriptive statistics is a way to collect the different types of data sets and present it in different forms. We can call it tables, bar graphs, pie charts, etc. So this way it helps to collect accurate quantitative data. Okay, so this way it plays very crucial role in different areas. So today we have seen the basic introduction to the statistics and the meaning of major disciplines of statistics. In next lecture we are going to start with the first chapter of our syllabus, that is correlation analysis. So guys, you just keep watching the lectures so that it will be of great help to you during the time of your examination, and it will help us to gain more and more knowledge. Okay, so keep studying, stay thirsty for the knowledge, and stay safe. Thank you.